for today's video lecture of maths. Today we are going to start with the second chapter of maths, that is Roman numerals. We have completed the first chapter, that is numbers. So in that chapter we have seen numbers of 7 digits, 8 digits and 9 digits. Okay, so that was the Indian system of numeration. We also call them as a Hindu Arabic numbers, because why, you know, those numbers or the digits in the those numbers were used by the Hindus or the Arabs, so that that number system is called as Hindu Arabic numbers. Hindu Arabic numbers. That is the numbers, Hindu Arabic numbers or numerals. That is the numbers which are formed by using the this symbol 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9. So the numbers which are made up by, or the numbers which are formed by these symbols or these digits, they are called Hindu Arabic numerals. Okay, because why, you know, these numbers or these symbols were used by the Hindus or the Arabs to form the numbers. So these numbers are called Hindu Arabic numerals. Okay, whereas the people from Rome country, that is Roman people, they used the Roman system of numeration. What was that system? In that system, see, that system is called Roman numerals. Roman system of numeration, that is Roman numerals. Okay, so for that they used English alphabets to represent the numerals. Basically, they use 7 alphabets to express, to form the Roman numerals. So which are those 7 alphabets? In earlier classes we have learned Roman numerals up till 100, right? So in that class you know the alphabets, those 7 alphabets which are used to form the Roman numerals. So let's write the symbols to write Roman numerals. The first symbol is of I. So I represent for 1. So this is Roman symbol and for this symbol, which is the Hindu Arabic numeral is there? I represent the Hindu Arabic numeral as a 1. Understood? So this is the first symbol, I. Another symbol is V. And that V represents which Hindu Arabic numeral? 5, right? V means 5. Then the next symbol is X, which represents the Hindu Arabic numeral 10. So I means 1, V means 5, X means 10. The next symbol is L, which represents the Hindu Arabic numeral 50. Got it? Then the next symbol is C. C means 100. C means 100. Then there is D, which represents which Hindu Arabic numeral? D means 500. D means 500. And the seventh one symbol is M, which represents 1000. Understood? So understood. So these are the 7 symbols, 7 alphabets which are used to form the Roman numerals. Understood? So you have to keep these 7 symbols in your mind, and the numerals, Hindu Arabic numerals for them. That means for I, 1. I means 1, V means 5, X means 10, L means 50, C means 100, D means 500, M means 1000. Okay. So these seven symbols are used to represent these seven numerals. Now, how to form other numbers, or how the other Roman numerals are formed? For example, I represent one. I represents one, but what is for two, three, four? We represent five. What about 6, 7, 8, 9? X represent 10. What about 11, 12, 13, 14, 20, 30, 40? L represent 50. What is for 60, 70, 80? C represent 100. What is for 200, 300, 400? D represent 500. What is for 600, 700? M for 1000, 2000, 3000, 5000. How to write them? That we are going to learn in this chapter. So these are the seven symbols. Pause this video and write in your notebook. Okay. After this, we will see how the other Roman numerals are formed, or there are some basic rules to form the Roman numerals. Okay. So after this, we will see the rules of writing Roman numerals. Let's learn the first rule of writing Roman numerals. See, first rule is repetition of Roman numerals means addition. So see here, what is meaning of this rule? Here there are seven symbols of Roman numerals which represent the Roman numerals. Okay, so repetition of these symbols means what? Addition. See, I means what? One. Okay. Then if I is repeated two times, I. What is the meaning of this? I is repeated two times means what? One I means one, and again one I means again one, means one plus one. This I means one plus this I means one. So when there is repetition of same symbol, that gets added. Okay. So one plus one, two. So I means 2. Then for 3, what can be written for 3? I. Understood? 3 times I. That is 1 plus 1 plus 1 is equal to 3. Okay. Then see, X means what? 10. X means 10. Then X means 2 times x. 2 times x means this 1x means 10, another 1x means 10. 10 plus 10. xx means what? 10 plus 10. Sometimes the students, where the students commit mistake, you know, they write this x means 10 and this x means 10. So it numbers becomes 1010. No, it's wrong. When any symbol is repeated in Roman numeral, when any symbol is repeated, the meaning of it is addition. That is x. X means 10 plus 10. That is 10 plus 10, 20. So 2 times X means 20. Remember, 2 times X means 20. Then what is 3 times X means? X. 3 times X means 10 plus 10 plus 10. That is 30. Getting? Then C means what? 1 C means 100. Okay. Then the CC means what? 100 plus 100. 100 plus 100. That is 200. Okay. And triple C. CCC means 100 plus 100 plus 100. That is 300. Understood? So repetition of Roman numerals, that means repetition of any symbol, means the addition. Those two symbols get added to each other, into each other. That is I means 1 plus 1, I means 1 plus 1 plus 1, that is 3. Otherwise you will write this way, I means 111. No, it's wrong. Their value gets added. Okay. So now you must be thinking that I have just repeated here I, X and C. What about this V, L, D, M? You must you must be thinking, what about this VLD? So let me tell you about them. See, V means what? 5, right? If we repeat V, then what we will get? 5 plus 5, 10. But we have special symbol for 10. So similarly for L means 50. Then if you repeat L, it becomes 100, right? 50 plus 50, 100. But for 100, we have another special symbol. Similarly for D, if you repeat D means 500 plus 500, it becomes 1000. So here also for 1000, we have a symbol. That means what, you know, this V, L and D. V, L and D are not repeated. V, L and D never repeat. Never repeated, okay. Then what about M? See, here if you observe this, I, X and C, I have repeated up to 3 times only. Either 2 times or 3 times. So that means I, X and C can be repeated. I, X and C can be repeated maximum 3 times. Can be repeated 3 times. V, L and D are never repeated. Then what about M? M can be repeated any number of times. Suppose you want to write 2 times 2000, then 2 times M. 3000, 3 times M. 5000, if you want to write 5000, then you will write 5 times M. Only M means 1000, right? Double M means, MM means 2000. M means 5000. But there is another way of writing 5000 or 10000 that I am going to tell you at the end of this lecture. So just in this rule, just keep it in mind that I, X and C, these three symbols can be repeated maximum 3 times, and repetition of these symbols means addition of their values, okay. V, L and D are never repeated. V, L and D are never repeated, and M can be repeated any number of times. Clear? Let's move towards the next rule. Rule number two. A smaller numeral written after larger numeral is always added to the larger numeral. Once again I repeat, a smaller numeral or a smaller symbol written after larger symbol or larger numeral added to the larger numeral, always added to the larger numeral. What is meaning of this? See, we have this symbol. Suppose there is XI. So in this, I is smaller symbol and X is larger symbol, and I is, that is, which is a smaller symbol, is written after larger numeral. I is after larger numeral, right? Written after larger numeral. So in this case, the value of I will get added in the X. So value of X is what? 10. Plus value of I is what? 1. Correct? So it becomes 11. 10 plus 1? 11. Means what? X means 10. And I means 1. Okay? So their value gets added. Understood? When smaller symbol appears after larger symbol. Is here smaller symbol after larger numeral or larger symbol? Yes. So in this case, their value gets added into each other's. That is 10 plus 1, 11. Understood? Similarly, if you want to write L, X, V. Now see, L is largest one here. After this symbol, X is smaller than L. Again, V is smaller than X. Okay. So Here see, smaller symbol is appearing after larger number. Here also see, smaller symbol is appearing after larger numeral. That means what? Their value will get added. See, value of L is what? 50, correct? Plus, value of X is what? 10. Then what is value of V? 5. So, the total value of this Roman numeral is 50 plus 10, 60. 60 plus 5, 65. So, LXV means nothing but 65. Understood? Otherwise, you will say, L means 50, X means 10, V means 5. 50,105, right? Is that correct? No. This is the correct answer, X 65. Or C L X X CLX. Okay, CLX will take. C means what here? 100. Plus L is smaller than C. L means 50. And X means 10. Okay, so their value will get added. That is 100 plus 50, 150, right? And 150 plus 10, 160. Understood? If there is CI, so I is, value of I is less than value of C. That means smaller symbol is appearing after greater symbol. So their value gets added. C means what? 100. And value of I is 1. That is 101. Understood? This is the meaning of this rule. When a smaller symbol return after larger symbol, that is always added to the larger numeral. A smaller numeral return after larger numeral is always added to the larger numeral. So it's get added in the larger numeral. Understood? Pause this video and write these two rules. We'll move towards the next rule. Rule number 3, a smaller numeral returned to the left of a larger numeral is always subtracted from the larger numeral. See what is meaning of this. A smaller numeral returned to the left of the larger numeral. Suppose there is one larger numeral V. Suppose V. And the smaller symbol than V is I. And it is returned to the left. Left side of the V, that is here, before V. Okay. I, which is smaller symbol, return before V or to the left of the V. In this case, value of I will be subtracted from value of V. See, in the previous rule, when we saw that, when a smaller symbol is written to the right of the greater symbol, that is after greater symbol, in that case the value of that smaller symbol was added in the value of larger symbol. And when smaller symbol is appearing before greater symbol, okay, so in this case the value of the smaller symbol is subtracted from the value of greater symbol. That is here I will be, the value of I, that is 1, will be subtracted from 5, value of V 5, that is 5 minus 1, 4. So IV represent 4. Understood? Because here see, I is appeared before V. So the value of I is subtracted. Similarly, IX. I is smaller symbol than X, right? The value of I is less than the value of X, and here I is appeared before the X, that is to the left of X. So in this case, value of I will be subtracted from X. That is value of X is 10 minus value of I, 1. So meaning of IX means 10 minus 1, that is 9. So IX means 9. Understood? See, XL. The value of X is 10, value of L is 50, and that means what? Value of X is less than the value of L, right? So now here, smaller symbol is appeared before the greater symbol or to the left of the greater symbol. So the value of smaller symbol will be subtracted from the value of greater symbol, okay? So value of L is 50 and value of X is 10. So 50 minus 10, that is 40. XL means what? 40. You might have heard this word XL. It is size to measure clothes. Okay. So XL means 40. Similarly, if there is XC. So X is smaller than C because value of X is 10 and C means 100, right? And when smaller symbol appeared to the left of the greater, in that case value of that smaller is get subtracted from the greater. That is C means 100 and X means 10 and it will get subtracted. That is 100 minus 10, 90. Okay? So XC means 90. Understood? Similarly, you will see here CM. Now C means what? 100 and M means 1000. So smaller symbol is appeared before the greater symbol or to the left of the greater symbol. So value of C will get subtracted from value of M. Value of M means 1000 minus 100. That is 900. So CM means 900, not chief minister here. CM means 900. Understood? Or CD. CD means, C means 100 and D means 500. So CD means 500 minus 100, that is 400. Understood? So what does this rule says? When smaller symbol or smaller numeral is written to the left of the greater numeral, larger numeral, in that case the value of smaller symbol or smaller numeral is subtracted from the greater symbol. Okay, let's move towards the next rule, rule number 4. This is quite complicated rule but easy to understand. See, a smaller numeral placed between two larger numerals is always subtracted from the larger numeral on its right. See here, I'll show, give you example. X, I, X. Now see here. X and X, their value is same and I is less than them. Okay, so I is smaller symbol and it is between two larger symbols or two larger numerals. So in this case, you must be thinking that when smaller symbol appears after greater symbol, its value get added. And when smaller symbol appears before greater symbol, its value gets subtracted. So what to do with this I? Either we should add it in the first X or we should subtract it from the second X. What to do? Don't get confused. The straight rule is there, that is when smaller symbol appeared between two larger symbols or two larger numerals, it is connected with the right one larger symbol. Okay, that is its value gets subtracted from the right side larger symbol. Okay, so here value of this X is 10 plus IX means what we have seen here. IX means 9, that is value of I will get subtracted from X, that is 10 minus 1, 9. That is this number IX means 19. Okay, they, see another example. LIX. Now see, L and X are larger symbol than I. I means 1, L means 50, I means 1, X means 10. Now you must be thinking that this I should be added in the L or should be subtracted from X. What will you do? It is clear, that is when smaller symbol appears between two greater symbol, it is connected with the next greater symbol or the greater symbol on its right side. So this value of I is subtracted from the value of greater symbol to its right. That is L means 50 plus 10 minus 1, 9, 59. LIX means 59. Understood? Similarly, see DXC. Okay, so see here, value of X is 10 here, value of D is 500, value of X is 10 and value of C is 100. So whether to add x in the 500 or should subtract from 100, that is from C. Yes, we need to subtract it from C, because when smaller symbol appear between two greater symbols, it is subtracted from the next greater symbol. So D means 500 plus x C means 100 minus 10, 90, that is 590. Understood? This is the meaning of this rule. Clear? Write down this in your notebook. Let's see rule number 5. The rule number 5 is the symbol this is called bar. So this symbol means it is a bar. What is use of this in the Roman numeral? See, if it is placed over a numeral or over a symbol, then the value of that symbol or value of that numeral is gets multiplied by 1000. Means what, you know, to represent 1000 we have m, but to represent larger number all the times we cannot repeat m. If you want to write 50,000, then can we repeat 50 times m? Means it is not convenient. So this bar is useful here to write the or to represent the larger Roman numerals. Okay, see, suppose we place the bar over V, that is V bar. Okay, what is meaning of V bar? Value of V is what? 5, correct? Value of V is 5. And meaning of as there is bar above V, that means the value of V gets multiplied by 1000, that is 5 into 1000, which is 5000. 1000 into 5, 5000. Understood? Or if we put bar over X, then value of X gets multiplied by 1000. So value of X means 10, and value of bar, meaning of bar means multiplied by 1000, that is 10 into 1000, 10,000. Understood? Suppose there is number X bar D C C C. What is meaning of this? X bar means what? 10 into 1000 plus D means 500 plus C means 100, that is 100 plus 100 plus 100, that is, this is 10,000 plus 500 plus this 300, 800. So 10,800, the value number, this number is 10,800. Understood? So bar over any symbol of Roman numeral, that means that value of that symbol gets multiplied by 1000. Clear? So these are the 5 rules we have seen today. Some examples we will see, and after that we will conclude this lecture. See, write in Roman numerals. These are Hindu Arabic numerals, and how to write them into Roman numerals. All the rules we have seen, and we have to apply those rules. So basically, see here, they have given 85. First example is 85. So 85 means 80 plus 5, but do we have symbol for 80? No. See, we have to split this 80 into the symbols, value of symbols. Which way? See, 85 means what? 80 plus 5, correct? 80 plus 5. We have value symbol for 5, that is V, but we don't have symbol for 80. So again, 80 we need to split. Which way to split? 50 plus 10 plus 10 plus 10. See, 50 plus 10, 60 plus 10, 70 plus 10, 80. Because 50 plus directly 30 also we don't have symbol. We have symbol for 10. So 50 plus 10 plus 10 plus 10 plus 5, that is 85. So 50 means what? L. 10, this 10 means X. X, this for this 10 X, and for this 5 V. So whenever we are going to write the Roman numerals for the given Hindu Arabic numerals, we need to split them into the values of the symbols given here. These values of the 7 symbols, we have to split that number into the values of these 7 symbols. Okay, 150. Now see, 150 means what? 100 plus 50. So do we have symbol for 100? Yes. Do we have symbol for 50? Yes. So here directly you will get number. 100 means C, 50 means L. CL, that is 150. Okay. See 335. 335 means 300 plus 35. Again 300 plus 30 plus 5. So in this 300 plus 30 plus 5, do we have symbol for directly 300 or directly 30 or 5? We have symbol for 5, but we don't have symbol for 330. So again we need to split that 300. Which way? See, we have symbol for 100, so we can split this 300 into form of 100, sum of 100, that is 100 plus 100 plus 100, correct? Plus 30 again, we don't have symbol for 30, but 30 means what? 10 plus 10 plus 10, okay, so 10 plus 10 plus 10 plus 5. Now we can write symbol for it. 100 means C, this 100 means C, this 100 means C. 10, 10, 10 means X, 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 and if for 5 E. So this is the number 335, see, 335. Similarly, we have to do for this 943. Now 900, directly we don't have symbol for 900, correct? 900 means, how to write 900? First of all, we will write this way, 900 plus 40 plus 3, 900 plus 40 plus 3, okay. Now, whenever we write 900, we will not write this way, now 500 plus 400, we will not write this way. Why, how to write the, write it? 1000 minus 100, 1000 minus 100. Understood? Then 40 means 50 minus 10, and 3 means 1 plus 1 plus 1. Got it? See, 100 minus 10. So whenever we have, there is subtraction, smaller symbol come first and greater symbol afterwards. Now here CM means 1000 minus 10. Again 50 minus 10 means XL. Right? And I. This 1 plus 1 plus 1 means I. So CM XL I. That is 943. Clear? Now see this. 1530. Now 1000 means what? This 1000. We have symbol for 1000. We have symbol for 500. We don't have symbol for 30, so we'll write 10 plus 10 plus 10. That is 1000 means M, D, X, X, X. Okay, so this is the Roman numeral for 1530. Understood? So today we have seen the symbols of Roman numerals as well as rules of writing Roman numerals. Also, we have seen some examples. Write down this in your notebook. In tomorrow's lecture, we will solve the exercise practice based on these Roman numerals. Okay. So, till that, thank you and have a nice day.